guys, it's Sydney, and I feel like I haven't seen you or talked to you in a while, and I'm sorry I did miss a week of uploading video. It's because I've been home alone with my sister for the past week, and you know, I didn't realize it's kind of hard to like sustain yourself, so I kind of had to take care of things and be responsible. So I'm sorry I missed an upload, and I can't tell you that it won't happen again. I'm just gonna try my best to upload weekly, and today I'm going to be telling you 5 awesome, I think they're kind of awesome, beauty tips that I have discovered or just kind of figured out over time. And yeah, let's get started. So the first tip is a hair tip, and it is kind of how to get like volumized hair. And I have very thick hair, but it's very heavy, so it kind of gets weighted down at the roots. So I've been using Herbal Essences Volume Shampoo. And if you don't want to get a volumizing shampoo, but you really just want to have volumized hair, I recommend when you are washing your hair, flip your hair over, like so, and wash like under, like this. I know it's kind of hard to see, but basically just wash your hair upside down, because I don't know what it does, but it works. I heard it somewhere, and I'm telling you, it really works. So that upside down hair trick for volumized hair plus volumizing shampoo really gives your roots like a lift, and I've seen such a difference. I'm telling you, it's awesome. Staying on the hair tips thing, the next one is if you are lazy and you want to look presentable. So I normally have very frizzy hair, and it's not something like really cute and wavy, it's like frizzy wavy. So if I'm extra lazy and I really just want to make my hair look like I did it but I don't have the time, I will often curl my hair, but I'll only curl like the top layer or the top portion. So I just curl like maybe 6 pieces, like 1, 2, 3, just from like here, not all of the lower stuff. And it saves you so much time, and it makes you look like you actually put effort into your hair and it looks fully curled, but it's not. And it's kind of awesome. And there's a plane outside, I apologize. And I'm using natural light, so the light might be changing a little bit, and I'm very, very sorry. Go away, plane. I'm filming. Please leave. Please leave. So the next tip is for your eyelashes. And I am someone with very dry eyelashes, and they tend to fall out kind of easily, like not a ton, but kind of. And a great way to moisturize them, if you don't want to invest in any like really nice serums or anything, is just using Vaseline. Before I go to bed at night, I put a little bit on my roots, and it kind of soothes that like itchy feeling, and it strengthens them, because when they are dry, they are more like to, I cannot speak. When they are dry, they are more likely to be weak and fall out. So this moisturizes them and stuff, like it keeps them healthy. But I recommend only doing this at night, because if you do it in the morning and you put mascara on, the greasiness of the Vaseline will not hold on to mascara and it will fall all over your face. So only do this at night, and it is amazing for helping your lashes. Tip number 4 is about powder and sponges. So here I have a sponge. Normally I would have my beauty blender, but I cannot find it at the moment. But if you have any sponge, obviously you can use it for foundation, concealer, and stuff like that, but you can also use it for powder. Since I am in the swim unit at school right now, I have to take as little makeup as I can possible to school, so I use this for my foundation and for my powder. So what I do is I take my pressed powder, I rub it in there, and powder will get on your sponge, and then you just dab it on your face, and it does the same thing, but I find it gives your powder a better finish. It's not as like powdery, like you just threw like chalk dust on your face. It's pressed into the skin, and it actually kind of mattifies your makeup for a longer amount of time and looks a lot more natural, and it saves space because it's like a multi-use product. It's pretty cool. The very last tip for this video is using a paint tray for your makeup. Now, normally when I apply foundation, I put a pump on the back of my hand, or just how much ever I want on my hand, and it always leaves like a stain, like an over throughout the day. I will have like makeup smearing on my clothes and it's not cute at all. So I bought one of these little paint trays from Meijer and I think this was like $2 or $3. It is so affordable and they sell very expensive like makeup mixing trays things, but I mean it's just like a flat platform so you can use anything, and I find that it helps you not waste product because you're not trying to rub it off on your hand, and it's easy to like, if it's not a pump, you can just kind of wipe it on the edge and it'll stop the flow. That sounded kind of weird. I like this for my concealer and foundation, and it makes it really easy if you want to mix shades because you can put like a little bit here and a little bit here and mix it together, and I find this is really nice and it keeps things organized and clean. Okay, so that is it for my 5 beauty tips video. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you found it helpful. If you did, be sure to tell me in the comments and leave any of your favorite beauty tips there as well. And if you liked it, give it a big thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. And of course, if you're feeling extra nice, please, please, please hit the subscribe button. I would love you, and you could join the Biscuit family, and we're pretty cool here, so you don't want to be left out. And that is it for this week's video. I love you so, so, so much, and I hope you guys had a wonderful day, and I will see all of you beautiful Biscuits next week. Bye! Oh my god, I'm always so far away. Bye! Now I'm 4 or 5 seconds from wildin', and we got 3 more days till Friday. I'm just trying to make it back home by Monday. Oh, and you guys, I got a new phone, and I have a really cute cactus phone case because you guys know I have an obsession with cacti. It's an issue, I'm sorry. But if you guys want me to do a what's on my phone video, I would love to. And while we're at it, you know what we should do? I'm gonna take a picture of you because you are just so beautiful. Okay, little update, peace out.